Theme: Introduction in Course of Histology. Histological Technique. Plan. Number 1. Introduction to Histology. Number 2. Types of histological preparations. Number 3. Technique of making of histological preparation. Taking of material and its fixation. Condensation of material. Sectioning. Staining of sections. And conservation. Histology is the branch of the morphological sciences that studies tissues of alive organisms. Human histology is science about structure, development, and vital activity of human tissues. Teaching of histology includes cytology, embryology, general histology, and particular histology. Cytology is science about structure, development, and vital activity of cells. Embryology is science about embryo and regularities of its development. General histology, science about development, structure, functions, and reactive changes of tissues of organism. Particular histology studies microscopic structure of organs of organism. Types of histological preparations. Histological preparations can be section, smear, pellicle, imprint. Section can be section of tissue or organ. Smear can be taken from bone marrow, smear and blood. Pellicle of pleura and peritoneum. Imprint of liver can be of thymus, for example. Histological slide is section of cell, tissue or organ with thickness 5 to 15 micrometers, stained by histological dyes. Tissue preparation. Various techniques have been developed to prepare tissues for study so that they closely resemble their natural living state. The steps involved are taking of material and its fixation, condensation, cutting, staining, and conservation. The first stage, taking of material and its fixation. Taking of material is made by two methods, autopsy and biopsy. Autopsy when organism is dead, and biopsy is taken from a live organism. Small portions of tissue, usually less than 0.5 centimeters in thickness, are removed from the animal as soon as possible after death and immersed in a special preservative fluid, a fixative. Fixation kills the cell quickly, stops the postmortem degenerative processes, and preserves the structural integrity of the cellular components of the tissue. Fixation is reached by two ways. Thermal treatment means freezing and embedding into fixatives. Fixatives can be spirit, formalin, buoyant fluid, solutions of salts of heavy metals, osmic acid. The most common fixative agents used in light microscopy are neutral buffered formalin and buoyant fluid. Both of these substances cross-link proteins, thus preventing them from altering their position, therefore maintaining a life-like image of the tissue. After fixation, parcels are washed during few hours for removing of remains of fixative. Dehydration. Because a large fraction of the tissue is composed of water, a graded series of alcohol baths, beginning with 50% alcohol and progressing in graded steps to 100% alcohol, are used to remove the water. The tissue is then treated with xylene, a chemical that is miscible both with alcohol and melted paraffin, This process is known as clearing because the tissue becomes transparent in xylene. Stage number 2. Condensation of material. Condensation of material is reached by two methods: thermal treatment and embedding into condensing medium. Thermal treatment means freezing by, for example, liquid nitrogen or on the rapid freeze bar of a cryostat. The fast method is freezing by fluid carbonic acid. Condensing mediums can be paraffin, celoidan, organic tars. For light microscopy, the usual embedding medium is paraffin. The tissue is placed in a suitable container of melted paraffin until it is completely infiltrated by that waxy substance. Once the tissue is infiltrated, it is placed into a small receptacle covered with melted paraffin and allowed to harden, forming a paraffin block containing the tissue. There are disadvantages in paraffin embedding. It is time-consuming and the clearing agents are lipid solvents, so this method cannot be used to demonstrate fats. Here you can see a paraffin block containing the tissue. Stage number 3. Sectioning or cutting. After the blocks of tissue are trimmed of excess embedding material, they are mounted for sectioning. The task of sectioning, in which thin slices are removed from the block, is performed by a microtome, a machine equipped with a blade and an arm that advances the tissue block in specific equal increments. For light microscopy, the thickness of each section is about 5 to 10 micrometers, and each section or series of sections is mounted on glass slides. In this slide you can see microtome, apparatus for cutting in light microscopy. Cutting for light microscopy is made on apparatus which is called microtome. In electron microscopy, this apparatus is called ultramicrotome. Here you can see that cube is placed into object holder of microtome. The object holder with cube moves for fixated distance. Knife of microtome cut thin layer from paraffin block. Paraffin sections are mounted on glass slides. Before staining, paraffin is removed from parcels by passing along battery of solutions: xylol, ethylene spirit from 100% till 70%, and water. Stage number 4. Staining of sections, which permit differentiation of the various cellular components. Staining for light microscopy is performed mostly with water-soluble stains. Therefore, the paraffin must first be removed from the mounted sections, after which the tissue is rehydrated and stained. After staining, the section is again dehydrated so that the cover slip may be permanently affixed by the use of a suitable mounting medium. The cover slip not only protects the tissue from damage, but also is necessary for viewing the section with the microscope. Stained preparations undergo to dehydration in spirits of increasing concentration and xylol, benzol, toluol, or in some oils. Histological dyes, can be two types: basic and acidic. The most commonly used stain in histology is hematoxylene and eosine. Basic dyes. To basic dyes are related hematoxylene, azur 2, carmine, which represents salts of staining bases. They preferentially color the acidic components of the cell into colors of blue, for example, dark blue, violet, light blue. Because the most acidic components are deoxyribonucleic acid and ribonucleic acid, the nucleus and regions of the cytoplasm rich in ribosomes stain dark blue. Histological structures stained by basic dyes are called the basophilic. Acidic dyes. Acidic dyes, eosin, picric acid, these are salts of staining acids. They usually stain structures into colors of red, pink, orange, yellow. Eosin is an acid that dyes the basic components of the cell a pinkish color, usually pinkish color. Because many cytoplasmic constituents have a basic pH, regions of the cytoplasm stain pink. These elements are said to be oxyphilic or acidophilic. Here you can see slide section of tongue, which is stained by hematoxylene eosin. Tincture property. Ability of histological structures to be stained by some dyes is called tincture property. Structures not reacting with dyes are called chromophobic. Stained structures are chromophilic. In some cases, for characteristic of tincture property, the name of dye is used. For example, pyroninophilic, it means stained by pyronin. Sudanophobic, it means not stained by Sudan. Structures stained by basic dyes are called basophilic. Structures stained by acidic dyes are called oxyphilic. Structures stained both by acid and basic dyes are called neutrophilic. And structures stained by salts of silver are called argyrophilic. Metachromasia. Molecules of some stains, such as toluidine blue, polymerize with each other when exposed to high concentrations of polyanion in tissue. These aggregates are of a color differing from that of their individual molecules. For example, toluidine blue stains tissue blue, except for those that are rich in polyanions. For example, cartilage matrix, granules of mast cells, which are stained purple. A tissue or a cell component that stains into another color, different from dye color, is said to be metachromatic. Here you can see some examples of staining of histological preparation. In this slide you see section of spinal cord impregnated by silver. In low magnification, gray matter of spinal cord is visible like butterfly or a letter H. In high magnification, neurons are visible. They are stained into dark brown color due to presence of neurofibrils in their neuroplasm. In this slide you can see blood smear, which is stained by Romanowski method. Romanowski method includes dyes azur 2 and eosin. In this slide you see great number of RBC erythrocytes, which are oxyphilic, and few white blood cells are visible. These are neutrophils, leukocytes. The next slide shows us cartilage of ear shell stained by orsein. Arrow shows isogenous groups of chondrocytes. Orsein usually stains elastic fibers. So, ear shell includes elastic cartilage, which is rich in elastic fibers stained by ocean. And in this light, myelinated nerve fibers are visible, stained by osmic acid. Osmic acid reveals lipids, which are present in myelin sheath of myelinated nerve fibers. So they are stained into brown color. Staining for electron microscopy. For electron microscopy, sections which were cut in ultramicrotome are put into special net. They are contrasted by salts of heavy metals, cobalt, lead, manganese. After that, they are seen in microscope and are photographed. Such microphotographs serve as object of study together with histological preparations. Stage number 5 for light microscopy. This stage is called conservation or embedding into conserving medium. For a long keeping, the histological section is put between stage glass and covering glass into conserving mediums. As conserving mediums, tars of coniferous trees and transparent hardened synthetic mediums are used. Microscopy. The main method of study of biological microobjects is microscopy. There are light microscopy and electron microscopy. Technical characteristic of microscope. Technical characteristic of microscope includes optical resolution and magnification. Optical resolution is the ability of the lens to show that two distinct objects are separated by a distance. Resolution of light microscope is 0.2 micrometers. Resolution of modern electron microscopes can reach 0.7 nanometers. Magnification of microscope is magnification of ocular multiplying for magnification of objective. Magnification of object in light microscopy reaches 0.5 to 2.5 thousandths times. In electron microscope, it reaches 150 thousand times. Types of light microscopy can be ultraviolet, luminescent, ultraviolet fluorescent microscopy, phase contrast microscopy, microscopy in phase dark field contrast, and confocal microscopy. Types of electron microscopy. Two types of electron microscopes are present: transmission and scanning. Transmission electron microscope uses much thinner sections compared with light microscopy and requires heavy metal precipitation techniques rather than water-soluble stains to stain tissues. Scanning electron microscopy provides a three-dimensional image of the specimen. Thank you for attention.